John, did you feel like you kind of simplified things out there and were kind of more willing to take some of the seam routes and some of the underneath stuff instead of, you know, going more focused on the deep ball?
I think our game plan just really, it was just my feet and my eyes, keeping them staying close to my fundamentals and doing those things. And then that's just how it turned out because the reads were open for that.
I know you had some frustrations last week, even with the win, and then against Boise State. Today, you have more touchdowns and incompletions between passing and running. What does this kind of do for your confidence in terms of going forward, you know, kind of reminding yourself of what you're capable of?
I mean, I think it's just a testament to the people in the building. You know, like, they reminded me they all believe in me, and they told me that. And I think I just got back to the work. You know, I'm glad it happened like this, but it was because – like the linemen they finished, you know, and the receivers they finished and they blocked downfield. Like, I don't score those two rushing touchdowns if Chris Hudson doesn't block. That block is critical, and that's is great. And they did a great job. I think just keep taking steps forward.
Was that the John Wall celebration after the touchdown rush?
I don't know where it originated, but I was thinking about him this week. I'm trying to celebrate more, just because it's good for the energy and the guys. And I was thinking of a couple, and then Carlos, I can't dance, right? So they got to keep it simple for me. But I asked Carlos and K-Dub, and they gave me that one. I haven't watched it. I hope it looked good. Felt good.
Yeah, I mean, it seemed like, you know, you're trying to get the ball out quicker. Was that, like, by design, or is that kind of what was open for you today?
I mean, they were giving us space. They were off and soft and inside on the corners, and then – in the RPO game, it was just there. And we trusted our guys. We told our receivers, block on the quick RPOs. And they did, and it was great, and it was working. That was the emphasis this week, and so I took it, and it worked.
You focused on, like, not – I mean, obviously, you know, you don't want to turn it over any time, but today was your first time not doing that since Portland State. Was that, like, a focus of yours, or is that just kind of the flow of the game today?
I think I was good with my eyes and my feet, and I think that's what happened.
This win means you guys are bowl eligible, and kind of just having it be your first year starting, maybe you're sitting on the bench last year watching them not get to a bowl game, and you get to kind of take the keys and help WSU get back to that spot. How does that feel for you?
Feels great. You know, getting extra time with all these guys is great. We get an extra month to be teammates, and, you know, with these seniors, like, it's when that day finally comes and it's over, it's very sad, right? So we get more time with them, and I'm just blessed for that, and it's cool. Like, it's a cool experience being bowl eligible, and we'll see where we land. It'll be fun.
And just what did you see? I know it's been a consistent thing trying to work on the defense, whether it's communication or just being able to, you know, finish those tackles. What did you see from those guys today? It looked pretty good, you know, from the sidelines.
Yeah, they look good, but it's just practice. Like, they're practicing and they're learning each other, getting better, and the chemistry of the defense and communication. They're doing a great job. They give me some fits in practice here and there, you know. I get mad about it, right? But it's because it's good defense. We got some good players. Buddha had a great game today. Just proud of them.
Jake said that he used the term that you guys have been narrowing the menu down for what really fits your game.
Talking about Coach Dicker?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
And you're good. And I was just curious, how does that feel when, you know, you really get into your groove, you guys are checking off these things throughout the season, and you know that, you know, your options are more your forte?
I think at this point it was an emphasis to – yeah, like you said, kind of narrow it down and just do the stuff we're good at. It worked out today, right? Put up a lot of yards and a lot of points. I think it's cool, right? Like, we have great coaches that are very clever, and they come up with some great ideas, you know. And some of those things I didn't, like, execute well enough early, so we kept it simple this game because it allowed that. Their defensive structure allowed that. And so we did it, and it worked, so it's cool.
John, I think you guys had close to like 10 rushing yards at halftime, and then you guys were really able to open up that part of your game in the second half. Was that something that you noticed at halftime when you were talking with your coaches, or how did that work out?
The runs were there the whole first half. I was taking a lot of RPOs. We ended up with 170 RPO yards, and that's legit, right? Now, so on a stat sheet, it looks like we only have 10 yards. But we call run plays, and I just throw it because the look is there. Like, how we do statistics is those are combined, right? So yeah, it looked like 10 yards, but the run game, the RPO game, was very efficient.
And on your two rushing touchdowns, just kind of, was that something that you kind of saw, or were they designed for you to take?
They were designed. Like, I had an option to throw it or run it, and then the second one to hand it or run it, and the looks that were there had me hand it or run it, sorry, and then just follow my puller, get to end zone.
How special was it to be able to throw Carlos his first college touchdown? What was that moment like for you?
It was cool. I wanted to do it last year, you know, when we got our opportunity against Colorado State. I threw him a slant. He just didn't make it to the end zone, right? But it was, that's like a year. That's a year and a couple months ago, right? So, and then he gets hurt, right? He comes back, and it's just great. Like, he only had one catch last week, and now he's the first touchdown of the game. Just very exciting. I'm super proud of that kid.
And Cooper Mathers talked about how he's been earning your trust and your coach's trust. And of course, you find him several times today. What has he been doing to kind of earn that trust? And what does he add to your offense?
He adds a lot. He's very versatile. He can block. He can run. He's really crafty, right? He does a lot of good things. And he's had my trust. I don't want him to think he hasn't had my. He's had my trust for a long time. It just, you know, the game flows, and I don't give him the ball a whole lot. Today was actually the first time he caught a pass that didn't end up in the end zone. Right, he had three catches. One of them was in the end zone, right? But it's cool. Kuba adds a lot, and I'm really proud of that kid.
Anything else for John?
I have the celebration. You want to?
Yeah. Let's do it. They said I was almost stiff.
It looks good.
I'd say that's a success. That's a success. It's good. Thank you for showing me that.
You're welcome. Thanks, John. Okay, anything else?
Thanks, John. Thank you, guys.